Are you getting a little confused about what field to add when you're building out your SmartSuite solutions? There's a lot of different available options to us in terms of when do we link to a different record? When do we use a formula? When do we use a lookup field? A lot of this can be confusing if you're new to no code in general. Well, if solving this once and for all is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. At the forefront of these tools is SmartSuite, an amazing software that allows us to get really organized and collect things in our databases that live in the cloud. With that, we can include automation and a lot of other advanced workflows that help us just get work done in a better way. So before we get into the video itself, if you want to follow along with me here today and just go through these steps yourself inside of SmartSuite, go ahead and open up your own SmartSuite applications. And if you don't have one already, use our link below this video. If you choose to use our link, when you upgrade to a paid account, if you choose to in the future, then you will be given some exclusive swag that you can't get anywhere else as a thank you for having checked out our channel. So go ahead and grab that link below. In addition to this, if you're new to automation in general, I want to also invite you to join me for my free training. It's going to teach you the fundamentals of no-code automation, and you can grab that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'll include all of these links below in the chat and description of this video, so be sure to check for those. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this and break down the key differences between three core types of fields that you'll add into your SmartSuite solutions. I'm talking about linked records, I'm talking about lookup fields, and lastly, we're gonna break down formulas. And at first glance, these three things might seem kind of similar, so let's talk about how they're different and what the unique circumstances are that will drive you to pick up one or the other. So let's start first with a linked record. So the idea here is that every single application that you build inside of SmartSuite is going to be its own unique set of data. Here inside of my screen, you see that I have ongoing projects first, and this is the solution. And then at the next level, we have our projects. So we have a specific set of data here called projects. And every time I add a new record here, this is going to be a new project. So this actually is gonna be new project two. Every new project is gonna have unique information to it. So who is responsible for this project? Let's add it to someone's calendar. Let's give it its own unique due date. Let's discuss the status of this project. Where is it in the process? So each project here is gonna be its own unique record or piece of information. And of course, nothing that we do exists in a vacuum. When we work on a project, it's gonna be on behalf of a client. And so here is where we're going to establish who the client is. And I've already created this field called link to contacts. The idea here is that we are gonna identify who the contact is. Now, we could just type in the contact information. We could say the contact is Gareth. His email address is gareth@gapconsulting.io. And then we can have an output for our formula as well. But the idea here is that we already have this information living somewhere else. Contacts, that's its own set of data. So this should be in a different application somewhere else. So here I am in a totally different application called Gap Contacts. And here I've got a couple of different applications, my clients and my organizations. So a client is assigned to an organization and we can track their information here. So I've got some sample data here and you can see here I am, I'm Gareth Pronovost with Gap Consulting. That's the company I represent. My name is here in a full name field, and we can also include email in a different field. So in this data set is where we're going to store all of the contact related information, but when we're working on our projects, we need them to relate to a person who is the contact for that particular project that we're working on. And so we're going to establish a linked relationship to clients here. And what we do is just say, hey, we're creating a new link, and we can tell this link what we're gonna look at. This application can live anywhere else, so it's inside of our solution called Gap Contacts, and we want to find the clients by linking to the client's application there. So that's how we set this up. And Again, once we establish this linked relationship, what that's going to do is then allow us to eliminate redundant data entry. We already have our contact information living somewhere inside of SmartSuite. And so the idea here is that we no longer have to go type it in every single time. We can just find it from the linked. And so here we have all the records that you just saw on my other application from my client's app. And so I can just pick them from the list. So that is when we want to use a linked relationship. Eliminate redundant data entry and identify that this information lives in a different area, and we're just going to link up to that directly. So then the next question becomes, well, when would you use a lookup field? And a lookup field pertains to bringing in information that already exists somewhere else that we've connected to. And the key takeaway here is that last part. We have to have already connected to that record, and we want to bring in some information that is assigned to that record. So here I've drawn up an example where we are bringing in the email address, and this is done through a lookup field. Remember, the email address, we know that information because it lives in the client's app. So if I were to flip back to that client's app, you see that I'm connected here to Gareth Pronovost with Gap Consulting on my other application, and what I want to know is, what's Gareth's email address? Again, this data lives somewhere else. So in the effort of eliminating redundant data entry, once I link to Gareth as a record for this particular client, I want to know certain things about that client. I could bring in phone number if we stored it. I could bring in address, etc. I don't want to change the data, and this is another key takeaway. When I'm using a lookup field, I don't want to modify that data in any way. I just want to bring in the related information that lives through that linked relationship. So here we are back then on my projects. And what I want to do is say, well, look, I have a link to contacts. And what I want to know is what's the certain information that lives on that contact record. And so in this case, I can access all the different fields that live in that application, my client's application. And so in this case, I'm bringing back the email address and I say update the field. And now when we change the contact, that email address will instantly be updated as well. Now this takes us to our third field type that we're gonna dive deep on here today, and that's the formula. When do you use a formula if you already have the ability to look stuff up? If you already have the ability to link to records that live somewhere else, why in the world do you need formulas? This has to do with when you want to change the output of some information. So in our formula example here, I'm using some information that lives in that linked relationship. I'm using that email address, but I don't just want to output the email address. I want to do it in a different format. So in this case, what I have is the output of the text block that says, this is the client email, colon, space, and then enter the client email. So how do we do this? We simply write a formula. We turn on our advanced editor, and we can use a concat formula to use multiple pieces of information to string them together. Now, this is just one example of formulas. You can have arithmetic formulas, you can have logic formulas, you can have textual changing formulas, all kinds of different things we can do in formulas to manipulate or change information that lives inside of our application and alter it to change it to what the kind of output we desire is. So in this case, the output I desire is a text block that says, this is the client email, and this part is what we call static, meaning that it's never going to change. So in my formula, I've hard-coded that as part of the text. But the part where things change is when we bring in information that lives at a different level. So you'll notice here that we have what is called dot notation. This allows us to look at our linked relationship to contacts and then bring back a specific field within the contacts application. So I'm telling SmartSuite to look at my link to contacts, but specifically look at the email address that lives there. And that's going to allow us to then bring back the email address just as the lookup field did, but this is using that lookup value inside of the formula. So this way, we don't actually have to burn a wasted field. We don't have to create a lookup field if all we want is the output to say, this is the client email, and then put in that email address. We don't need to create first that lookup field. We can just write the formula to create that output for us here. So now that we understand the differences, let's actually see this all in action. I'm going to give Matt here an example email address. He'll be matt@example.com or something close to it anyway. Now that I've got that typed up, let's get back to our project application and let's add Matt as a contact here. And you're going to see that once we build that linked relationship to Matt, all of the other information fills out for us. We're able to look up that email address that lives in that client application that we've linked to, and also the formula is smart enough to automatically update with that relevant information as well. So these are the core takeaways in terms of when you use these different pieces. You're going to ask yourself the following questions. If you are thinking you might need a linked relationship, the timing is right if you're saying that that's a different set of data. So if you have a different set of data that lives in a different solution or a different application, that's when you need that linked relationship to eliminate redundant data entry. Now, if you already have that information living in your linked relationship and you just need to bring it back without altering the way it shows up, then you're looking for a lookup field. The lookup field is going to reach through and just grab that information, not change it in any way, and present it in your other application. And then lastly, if you're looking to alter some information that lives somewhere else, you want to change the way that it shows up, then you're probably in the market for adding a formula. I know we went super fast in this video, especially if you're new to tools like SmartSuite. So be sure to grab that training that I mentioned in the beginning to get that strong foundation that you'll need. And if you want to make sure to see more content like this as you strengthen and grow your skills in no code, please consider subscribing to the channel. That's it for this video. I will see you in the next one. As always, I hope you found this to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website to see how we can help. We offer an exclusive free training that teaches the fundamentals of no-code tools, including automation. We also have some paid services available, including advanced courses, no-code hourly consulting, as well as custom project consulting. So swing on by to get the help you need, and we look forward to connecting with you soon.